There we go. First keeper of the day, guys. Bam! First keeper of the day. We're gonna break this down to try to make sure that we figure out what's going on. We got a fickle bite. It's the summer. It's tough, no doubt about it. We're gonna rip through some hair jigs. We've got a paddle tail going now. We're gonna go with your traditional minnow style, okay? Different minnow styles. And we're gonna see if one makes a difference regardless. That's our key. We might even throw in some bait pop. We're gonna throw the stealth mode asteroid at them. And we've got the hammer 10. That's what we're gonna fish with. And we just caught our first fish on a paddle tail. I can say that the bite is, we're relatively early in the morning, so the bite is still kind of finicky. It seems like it always picks up roughly around 9 o'clock. So that's gonna be the hot spot. But we're gonna keep going through these baits, and I'll let you know what I'm fishing with, just so that you can evaluate as well. I'm certainly gonna give you my honest opinion on it. An assortment of hair jigs right here. So right off the bat, we're gonna go ahead and switch. I'm not switching the hammer 10 at all today. I'm gonna stick with the stealth mode asteroid, and because I want certain things have to stay constant. And so we're just gonna be changing out the baits, which makes sense, right? So that's what we're gonna go for. I'm gonna go right out with a gumdrop hair jig. That's what we're gonna fish with next. All right, here we go. Gumdrop in action. Let's see. We got a horrible loop knot on this one, but we're going with it anyway. When I'm fishing by myself, the loop knot doesn't have to be super perfect, but I try to make it. But right now, definitely not. Uh-oh, that was first cast, guys. They might like the smaller profile. Uh-oh. Very interesting. Let's do it again. The first cast with the gumdrop, and it was the first cast and a fish. So it could be a profile deal. That was pretty nice. We're going down again to see if it was the real deal or not. Uh-oh, he bit that too. We going again. Oh my gosh. He wanted that one. That's a good fish there. That's a solid fish right there, guys. That's three casts with the gumdrop, two fish. All right, guys, I want to stay on this pile since I've had about maybe six casts with this guy. And definitely when I first threw it down there, they were all over it. And now it's kind of slowed up. But right now, he's the winner, gumdrop. But we're gonna put your standard middle style now on, and we're gonna give that a rip. We're gonna go with the gold jig head. It'll make it somewhat unique. You can get this at 3poundfishing.com. I don't know of any other manufacturers for that matter that carry a gold jig head, but we've had a lot of success here lately on it with the gold. And so that's why I'm putting it on there. I could use black, I could use any color I wanted, but we're going with the gold. And I'm gonna show you that. We're gonna try a couple different minnow style. The first one I'm gonna go with is the E-Frog, okay? This is also on 3-Pound Fishing's website. The reason why I'm going with this one right off the bat is it's super loud, obnoxious color. I just wanna see if color is a factor. And then we're gonna go with your natural white monkey milk style. The only thing that might be a disadvantage for this pile is that these fish have already had, you know, two baits over it, and so those active fish are gone, probably not as much, but we're gonna see what happens here. For me, it's also just fish that are just tracking it and running, so even if they don't close the gap, I can tell whether or not it's got their attention. Boy, there's something they don't like about that. There's definitely something they don't like about this one. Now, it could be just this pile, so what I'm definitely gonna do is go to a new pile with it, just to give it a, but they're following it, which is, again, step one. But they are definitely backing off. Of course, now I'll probably get a bite, but let's see. Now, he nipped it. He nipped it just a tiny bit. So we might definitely gonna go for a different pile. Oh baby, we had a fight for that fish, but we got one. Well, the proof is you could pretty much catch one with it, but we had to work at it. There it is, E-frog, gold head, good solid fish. Let's talk about it.
I don't feel they were closing in on that fish at all, or that bait, I'm sorry. Really tough. So I'm gonna take it off real quick, and I'm going to go with a, actually I should keep this gold on, shouldn't I? Yes, I think I should keep this gold on. So we're going to do a loop knot real quick, and then we're going to put a white bait back on. I think staying consistent with the head is important. Right now, my vibe is size matters, and small is way better. So I could even cut these down. But again, for consistency, just to see if it's a color issue, I'm going to stay same jig head. All I'm going to do is change up the color. Again, these are available at... 3-pound fishy. This is the, I forgot what it's called actually. There's an assortment of plastics on the website, guys. All right, this is what we're gonna fish with. Now that is complete contrast to what we just got done fishing in terms of colors. So we're gonna see if color matters. We just might move to another pile with this jig too, just to see. Yeah, so another follower here, and then we got one. So, only the third cast with this bait, and I've already got it, and this is a good fish here. I can tell this is a good one. And they were staying with it. There it is right there. They were staying with it a lot longer than with that black one. So even after just three casts, I can tell you they stay longer with it. Plus, they come up way closer to it. So they're definitely intrigued by the color. That's my personal opinion. Who knows? We don't talk fish, right? Now this is going to be a real good challenge here. Not even a challenge, really. This is the first couple casts on a brand new pile with this bait that I'm pretty excited about right now. So that's going to tell me a lot. First cast. Got one. Really had to play that fish, though. All right, guys, we got one with it on a new pile. There it is, okay? Good solid fish, good eater. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go to a different color hair jig and try something else right now. Right now, I'm very impressed by this jig. This is my favorite, probably over even the hair jig or the paddle tail. But we're gonna try a drastically different color with a hair jig. I think add some white with some black. So contrast is a big factor for me. I think contrast is a big deal. And that's what I want to try out. Now we did have the contrast with the gum, the bubble gum, the gumdrop hair jig, but we're going to try something a little different here. Let's see. So let's go with this guy. Available on the website again. Chartreuse white. A lot of contrast there in color. Obviously you could even do more so if you wanted to go with the black, but I'm trying to stay with that chartreuse color because we don't have much other than that E-frog. E-frog didn't do well, but I have a feeling it has to do with that black. But again, all speculation, we never know. But we're ripping through them and I like it. And this is a small profile, even smaller than that gumdrop. So this is gonna also help us understand if the actual size of the bait matters.
I love fishing with hair jigs. You guys know that, right? It's efficiency. You don't have to worry about plastics. They last for a very long time. To me, they absolutely equal more fish in the boat. And we got a follower right off the bat. But look, he peeled away extremely fast. Like, did not stay with it. We are going to go to a new pile with this jig, too. I really want to see if it... It's a beautiful looking jig right now, but I don't know. All All right, we got one with it. Vertical presentation with this guy.
All right, I've tried and tried with this one, and it just isn't going to work out for this guy. So I'm going to say that it's definitely not a chartreuse thing. They're not interested in the chartreuse. It might not even be a side thing, but that guy didn't work too well. We did get one fish off it, so to be fair, I think that if they're eating, they're eating. But I can tell you, I felt like I had the most action with that gold head, white body. But all right, guys, we got some great fish in the boat. I'm going to conclude that without a doubt, there's a difference in water displacement between a hair jig and plastics. We know there is. My thing is, though, right now it just seems like, you know, this style jig right here seems to be the key. The hair jig, the gumdrop, after putting it back in the water, just did not get the action that this guy was getting. So water displacement makes a big difference. That means the difference between fishing with a paddle tail, a minnow style plastic versus a hair jig, big deal. And I think it really does come down to probably action. So when I talk about why one or the other, it's probably action. It's jumping it around. That's my conclusion on today. That doesn't mean it's going to apply for the rest of my life or anything like that. I think there are times that contrast and color is a big factor. I do think size is a big factor. But right now, without a doubt, on my lake, action matters and plastic definitely matters. And I will say this, that the color of the e-frog didn't have the attention that this guy had. So color probably does have a factor, dark versus natural colors. So anyway, that's just me doing a little something, and it doesn't, you know, that might not obtain, apply to you guys on your lakes, but on my lake, that's what I'm dealing with. And definitely gonna stick with plastics here for at least the short term for sure. Thanks guys for watching. Please subscribe.